Hello. Hello, welcome. Hi, Victor.
Hi, teacher.
Welcome. Give me a second. Okay, how are you today?
I'm fine, thank you. And you?
Okay, I'm very fine. Thank you. Okay, it's almost time to start. We're going to start with a review, repaso. Review, okay? Now let me share you my screen. Just give me a second. Okay. Okay, opening the document. Okay, I'm ready. Course number 3, section 1. Okay, we are ready. Hello, Rolando, welcome. The microphone, Rolando, enciéndalo. Turn on.
Fine, teacher.
Welcome. Alonso, welcome, Alonso.
Hi, good evening.
It's a pleasure. Monica Monterrosa, welcome. Welcome.
Good evening.
It's a pleasure to hear you, right? Let me see, Victor Martinez, Rolando. Okay. Alonso. That's it. Now let me share my screen. Start with the review. Okay. And we're going to start with the word power. Special occasions, right? Special occasions.
After you complete this activity, share your work with everyone. In this class, you'll learn vocabulary for.
Okay. Give me a second. Okay.
We're discussing how to celebrate special occasions. Let's start by listening to the vocabulary on this picture.
Mother's Day. Father's Day. Graduation. Wedding. Anniversary.
Send cards. Give presents. Take pictures. Sing songs. Dance. Eat cake. Have a party. Have a picnic. Eat special food. Wear special clothes.
Now it's time to put these vocabulary words into practice. I would like for you to describe your plans for each of these special holidays. Mother's Day, Father's Day, graduation, wedding, anniversary. Let me give a quick example. I'm going to take pictures for my daughter's graduation. I'm going to.
Okay, we finished this yesterday. Now I'm going to read your commentaries. Okay, it's Carolina de Angulo says, I'm going to give presents for your wedding. Okay, thank you very much. I'm going to sing songs for my graduation. Nice. I'm going to eat special food for Mother's Day. Nice. That's it, right? Alicia Colorado. Nice. I'm going to eat special food for Mother's Day. I'm going to have a party for Father's Day. Thank you for the fathers. Eh? Nice. I'm going to eat cake for my niece's wedding. Now I have other student here. Let me see. Billy Peña. I don't understand. I'm going to take pictures, I imagine, right? I'm going to take pictures for Father's Day. I'm going to wear special clothes for the Christmas. We miss an S. Nos faltó una S aquí nada más. Okay, and Rolando, very good. Look, I'm going to take pictures for Mother's Day. That's it, right? Thank you for your commentaries. I like the commentaries, right? And let me see, we're here and we're going to review the reading, right? Let's listen.
Hi, everyone. In this class, you'll develop skills in scanning and reading for details by reading an article about birthday celebrations in different countries.
What are you going to do on your birthday? Elena Buenaventura, Madrid.
My 21st birthday is on Saturday, and I'm going to go out with some friends. To wish me a happy birthday, they're going to pull on my ear 21 times, once for each year. It's an old custom. Some people pull on the ear just once, but my friends are very traditional.
Yanqing She, Taipei.
Tomorrow is my 16th birthday. It's a special birthday, so we're going to have a family ceremony. I'm probably going to get some money in lucky envelopes from my relatives. My mother is going to cook noodles. Noodles are for a long life.
Mr. and Mrs. Aoki, Kyoto.
My husband is going to be 60 tomorrow. In Japan, the 60th birthday is called Kandeki. It's the beginning of a new life. The color red represents a new life. So children often give something red as a present. What are our children going to give him? A red hat and vest.
Philippe Joly, Paris.
I'm going to be 30 next week, so I'm going to invite three very good friends out to dinner. In France, when you have a birthday, you often invite people out. In some countries, I know it's the opposite. People take you out.
Okay, now, let's read the commentaries. Commentaries, oh, Alicia Maria Colorado. I'm going to turn 42 on May 8th. Usually my family cooks barbecue. We love meat. And the celebration is eating. I imagine eating a cake, right? Nice. Thank you very much, Alicia. Carolina de Angulo, again, good commentaries. Listen, my birthday is on June 17th. It's a very special date because it's Father's Day. Ah, nice. Double celebration, right? Father's Day and birthday. We're going to have a special dinner with my family. And we're going to eat cake. Nice. Good. I don't know the name of this student. Por aquí no me pusieron el nombre, pero vamos a leerlo. It says, my birthday is on December. Remember, December is with capital letter, right? Mayúscula.
Mayúscula.
My husband celebrates me with a cake. My family is going to sing. It's not our, right? Is going to sing the happy birthday. I'm excited. Okay. Happy birthday to you. Okay, nice. Very nice. Thank you for your commentaries. I like your commentaries, but please continue making commentaries, right? Good. Now, we're going to go to knowledge check, right? We're going to check it together. Okay. Let's read this part, right? Listen, please. Mm-hmm. My 21st birthday is on Saturday, and I'm going to go out with some friends to wish me a happy birthday. They're going to pull on my ear 25 times, once for each year. It's an old custom. Some people pull on the ear just once, but my friends are very traditional, right? Okay, according to this, to celebrate her birthday, Elena's friends are going to pull her ear 21 times, it says, right? Okay, let me see. Ana Carolina, please. Is that true or false? Hello, Carolina, welcome. Hello, hello? No, okay. Let me see. No. Marlene Ayala. Marlene Ayala, please tell me if it is true or false. Is true or false, Marlene? Hello, hello, can you hear me? Hello, hello. Okay, Victor, can you hear me, Victor?
Yes.
Yes, okay, thank you very much. Let me check, por aquí tengo un mensaje antes de ir, Victor. Bueno, no escucho nada, dice Elizabeth. Tengo problemas con el sonido. Victor, ¿usted me puede escuchar, Victor? ¿Me escucha bien?
Yes, teacher, I can.
Okay, yeah, thank you. Rolando, ¿usted me escucha bien?
Excelente, teacher.
Okay. Mónica. Hello, Mónica. ¿Me escucha bien, Mónica?
Excelente, teacher.
Okay. Es que veo que algunos están teniendo problemas con el audio, pero no somos nosotros, entonces. Good. Now, Victor, help me, please. True or false?
True.
True. Okay.
Yes.
Thank you. Let's continue. Next one. This is Yan Chin Shi, right? Tomorrow is my 16th birthday. It's a special birthday. So we're going to have a family ceremony, she said. I'm probably going to get some money in lucky envelopes from my relatives. My mother is going to cook noodles. Noodles are for a long life. Now, Rolando, please tell me, Rolando. Oops, sorry. Here, right? Excuse me. Give me a second. Oops, again, I don't know what happened. Sorry, I'm having troubles. And having troubles with this. Okay. Now, finally, okay, here we are, right? I'm sorry for the inconvenience. Now, number two, Yanchin, Rolando, is going to cook some noodles on her birthday. True or false?
True.
True.
Yes.
Okay. Nice. Number three, I will read from here, right? Vamos a leerlo desde aquí. Let me see. Mr. and Mrs. Aoki, Kyoto, my husband is going to be 60 tomorrow. In Japan, the 60th birthday is called Kanreki. It is the beginning of a new life. The color red represents a new life. So children often give something red as a present. What are our children going to give him? A red hat and a vest. Okay, Monica, I'm sorry. On his birthday, Mr. Aoki is going to receive something red. That is true or false?
Monica? True, teacher.
True. Okie dokie. Nice, thank you very much. And finally, Philippe Jolie, Paris. I'm going to be 30 next week, so I'm going to invite three very good friends out to dinner. Like we say in El Salvador, tres buenos cheros, right? In France, when we have a birthday, you often invite people out. In some countries, I know it's the opposite. People take you out, right? Now, let me see. Catherine, Philip's friends are going to take him out to dinner on his birthday. Is that true or false?
True.
Sorry? True.
Yeah.
Yes, okay, good. Now let me check. Let me check. Okay. Yes, number one is correct. Number two, Yanchin is going to, no. Yanchin, no. Her mother, la mamá, es la que va a cocinar, right? Yes?
Yes.
Okay, continue. On his birthday, he's going to receive something red. That's good, true. And Philip, no, sorry. The Philip friends are going to, los amigos de Philip lo van a sacar a comer. No, el cumpleaños de Francia al revés. El cumpleañero es el que invita a comer. Yes?
Right. Yes.
¿De casualidad alguno de ustedes no está cumpliendo años para que me invite? No.
Ya pasó, teacher.
Kidding, right? Y no estamos en Francia tampoco. Okay. Good. Let's continue. So, false, right? Okay, good. That's it. Any extra question? Now we'll stop. Listen. Hasta este momento ya tenemos que haber terminado la sección 1. Pregunta, ¿ya la terminaron todos? ¿O aún falta? ¿Le faltan algunos ejercicios? Yes.
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 Si no, ahorita, si no han hecho alguno y no entienden o les salió mal, pueden decirme ahorita. Y lo chequeamos juntos. Me pueden decir, mire, teacher, en esta no me salió buena o... O mire, yo no entendí la otra, etcétera, etcétera. Elizabeth, ¿ya me puede escuchar, Elizabeth? Hello? Hoy sí. Yes. Hello, Elizabeth? No.
No, teacher, en el... grupo de WhatsApp dijo de que no podía
entrar.
Sí, no,
que tiene problemas. Bueno, sorry, sorry, Elizabeth. Espero que por lo menos nos escuche. No nos puede hablar, pero nos escuche. Okay, good. I repeat, right? Don't be afraid. No tengan miedo, no tengan problemas de si no entienden algo. Yo estoy aquí para ayudarlos. No hay problema, yes? Okay, so officially we finish the section one, right? Entonces, oficialmente hemos terminado la sección 1. Now let's go to section number 2. And the class of today. Section 2. What's the matter? In Spanish, what is the problem? What is the situation, right? And so to start with this, I'm going to share the PowerPoint presentation for today. Por aquí tengo un mensaje. Escucha bien, Elizabeth, solo que no puede utilizar el micrófono. Thank you, Elizabeth. Ok, entonces ahí no se escucha. Ok. Now, let's go to the presentation. Ok. Can you see it? Alejandro Monsor, ¿puede ver la pantalla, Alejandro? Yes?
Yes,
sí, se ve. Okay, thank you, Alejandro. Okay, let's continue. For today, section number 2, word power, parts of the body. Yes. Number 3, the formula have plus noun. Feel plus adjective. Tener más un nombre, sentir más un adjetivo, right? And we are going to read the conversation, I feel homesick. Extraño mi hogar, right? Number 2.6, vocabulary, common medications. Okay, so this is the class for today. Now, let's start with the objective, right? With the objective. Let me see. Marlene, can you read the objective for today, please, Marlene? Hello, Marlene. Marlene. No, okay, so Billy, help me, Billy. Hello, hello. Yes. Es que veo que varios no me escuchan.
Hello.
Hello, Billy. I'm listening. Sí lo escucho, Billy, pero ¿usted me escucha bien?
Sí, sí, lo escucho sí. Bien.
Okay, thank you very much. Okay, now, Billy, can you read the objective for today, please?
At the end of the class, we'll learn vocabulary for discussing part of the body.
Okie dokie, thank you.
Okay.
Now the vocabulary. Listen, please. Head, chest, stomach, hip, knee, ankle, neck, shoulder, arm, back, leg, hand, finger, fingernail, toe, foot, toenail, chin. Oh, only that, right? Okie dokie. Now, repeat after me, please. Repeat after me. Head.
Head.
Turn off your microphone off, please. Microphone off. Thank you. Now, chest. Stomach. Don't say stomach. It's stomach. Stomach. Hip. Knee, ankle, neck, shoulder, arm, back, leg, hand, finger, fingernail, toe, foot, toenail, chin. Good. Any question? Do you understand the parts of the body? Questions? Yes?
Teacher.
Yes, tell me.
What mean toenail?
Toenail. For the hand, we say fingers, right? And this is fingernail for the hands. But for the foot, for the legs, for the foot, in this case, it's a, you don't say fingers. No, you say toe, the toes, right? And okay. The toenail is the nail, but for the foot. Understand?
Okay.
Okay, like this. Look. Hand, finger, fingernail. Hand,
fingernail.
Fingernail, right. Foot. Toe, then in this case means dedo de los pies, right? Or like in El Salvador, we say for the men, right? The jocote, right? Okay, and the toenail is the la uña, right? Una uña del dedo del pie. Okay, good. Thank you. Now, another question? Okay, now, listen, we're going to play a game, right? We're going to try to play a game. Listen. Vamos a tratar de hacer un juego. I'm going to start with Victor, Rolando, and Alicia. Victor, Rolando, and Alicia, right? We're going to play Simon Says. Simon Says. Have you played Simon Says before? Yeah, who was Simon Says? Yes?
Yeah.
So when I say Simon, you have to do like Simon, right? But if I don't say Simon, don't do it. No, don't do it, right? Let's practice.
Yeah.
Listen.
Simon, you're not says, teacher.
Sorry? No, you
know.
Nunca jugado. No.
No.
Okay. Listen, Rolando, when I say Simon, you do it. Cuando yo le diga Simon, usted lo va a hacer, ¿ok? Cualquier cosa que yo haga, ¿yes?
Ok.
Pero si no digo Simon, no haga nada. Queda quieto, ¿ok? Tiene que escuchar primero Simon. Simon dice, right? Simon says.
Okay. Okay.
Let's practice, let's practice. Simon says, let me see. Simon says, touch your stomach. Come on, Alicia, you're playing, Alicia. Okay, good. Simon says, touch your head. Simon says, touch your hand. Simon says, touch your shoulder. Touch your head. Touch your head. Ah, come on. Eliminate. No, don't say it. Don't make it, right? Remember. Okay, one more practice. Ready? Second opportunity. Le vamos a hacer, le vamos a otra oportunidad porque estamos bien. Okay, ready? Simon says, touch your chin. Your chin. Simon says, touch your chin. Simon says, touch your nose. Touch your head. No, Victor, I'm sorry. Okay, so the winner is Alicia. Okay, good. Thank you, Alicia. Now, the next one, let me see. Billy, Alejandro, Alonso, and Elizabeth, right? Ready? Alejandro, can you open your camera? ¿Podría abrir su cámara, Alejandro? Alejandro, please.
Yes, teacher.
Okay, open your camera, please. Vamos a ver, okay? Okay, now, ready? Ya vieron cómo jugamos, okay? Now, ready? Simon says, touch your shoulder. Simon says, touch your mouth. Simon says, touch your head. Touch your arm. Touch your arm. I'm sorry, Elizabeth. I didn't say I'm sorry. Okay, only Alonso, Alejandro, and Billy. Ready? Simon says,
okay.
Your stomach. Simon says, touch your hand. Touch your nose. Simon says, touch your shoulders. Simon says, touch your head. Touch your shoulders. Touch your shoulders, your shoulders. Touch your shoulders. Touch your hand. Touch your hand. Touch your hand. Touch your nose. Simon says, touch your shoulders. Simon says, touch your head. Touch your hand. Touch your stomach. Okay, come on. Billy, Alejandro, and Alonso, you're really good. Congratulations. You're the winner, right? Thank you. Let's go to the next one. Next group, right? Marlene, Monica, Luis Alberto, and Catherine. Can you open your cameras, please? Monica, thank you, Monica. Catherine, puede abrir su.
Voy en el micro.
Okay. Don't worry. So only, let me see, Marlene, Monica, and Luis Alberto, right? Give me a second. Luis Alberto. Hello, Luis. Luis.
Hello, teacher. Good evening.
Good evening. ¿Podría abrir su cámara para hacer el juego, Luis? Yes.
Ok, la tengo bien.
Ok, let me see.
Solo estoy del celular.
Del celular, no está hablando. Ok, let me see. Vamos a ver si se puede entonces.
Sí.
Ahí está Josué también. Okay.
No, teacher, Josué viene en camino, viene manejando.
Ah, okay. Está difícil. Entonces solo con Marlene y Mónica lo vamos a hacer. Vamos a ver. Ready, Marlene?
Perdón, teacher, pero he estado fuera porque el internet me está fallando y casi que no escucho. No sé qué es lo que tengo que hacer.
But now, ahorita me escucha.
Más o menos.
Más o menos. Bueno, entonces ya ingresó Ana María también. Entonces lo vamos a hacer con Mónica y Ana María, porque Marlene no nos escucha bien.
Correcto, teacher.
Ana María, can you play the Simon Says? ¿Ya vio cómo estamos jugando, Ana María? Yes? Simon Says, right? Okay.
When Hola.
Ana María, when I say Simon Says, you do, right? What I say. Cuando yo diga Simon Says, usted va a hacerlo. Lo que yo le voy a mostrar. Pero si no digo,
okay.
Digo Simon, no lo hago. Okay. Let's practice. Simon Says, touch your cheek. Come on, Ana María. Simon Says, touch your cheek. Okay, good. Simon Says, touch your head. Simon Says, touch your chest. Touch your hands.
Ah, no.
Ah, no. Okay, Ana María. ¿Alguna pregunta sobre las partes del cuerpo? ¿No?
Le escucho ante recortado, teacher.
Okay, no. So let's continue.
No question, no question.
Okay. Thank you. Now let's continue. Now let's go to the next part. Listen. Let me see. Mónica, can you read the objective for this class? It's a little bit long, right? It's un poquito largo. But can you read, Mónica, please? Mónica?
Hi, yes. Teacher.
Read the book, the objective, please. Read the objective, please.
Can you repeat, teacher?
Okay, Mónica, I need you read the lesson objective for the class.
Okay. Lesson objective. By the end of this class, you will learn how to use have
plus
no and
plus is más, símbolo más in English is plus.
To use have plus no and feel plus adjective to express health problem. Additionally, you will practice a conversation which
illustrates
how this topic is used in real life setting.
Life setting. Thank you very much, Monica. So in this case, have plus noun, feel plus adjective. To express health problems, problemas de salud. Okay? In a conversation, how to use this in a real life setting. That means en una situación de la vida real, right? Okie dokie. Now. Vocabulary, right? For this part, listen. Matter, headache, backache, the flu, homesick, better. Now, repeat after me, please. Matter, headache, backache, the flu, homesick, better. Good. Now, these are part of the conversation, right? So, do you have any question about this vocabulary?
All teacher.
No?
All teacher. All.
Sorry, all, you mean?
All the words.
Ana María, entiendo que no las entiende las palabras. Hello, Ana María.
Correcto. No la
entiendo.
Okay. Sí, no puede traducir todas.
Ninguna. Okay, understand. Matter is asunto, situación, problema. Okay? Headache is a problem in your head, when your head hurts. Cuando me duele la cabeza, right? And backache is when my back hurts. Cuando me duele la espalda. And ache means dolor. H is pronounced ache. is dolor. So headache, dolor de cabeza. Backache, dolor de espalda. Dolor de oídos, earache. Okay.
Earache. Oh.
The flu is la gripe. La gripe, right? The flu. Homesick means extrañar el hogar. Enfermarse de sentimientos por su hogar, ¿verdad? La diáspora salvadoreña en Estados Unidos cuando oyen el himno, ¿verdad?
Nostalgia, entonces.
Nostalgia, that's correct. Allá se ponen a llorar en Estados Unidos al oír el himno salvadoreño, ¿verdad? So, homesick. Better is mejor. So, for example, when I say, I feel better, ya me siento mejor, I feel better, right? Okay, understand? Questions? Good, let's continue, please. Let's continue. Sure. Now. Yes, yes, yes.
Una pregunta, ¿dolor de muela?
Is toothache. Toothache. Solo ponemos aquí la palabra tooth y luego H, right? Toothache. Dolor de muela, dolor de diente, right?
Okay.
Okay, good. Now, have plus noun, feel plus adjective. Have plus noun, listen. I have an earache. I have a pain in my chest. A pain in my chest. I have a pain in my ribs. Oh, pain in my ribs, right? Ribs. I have a fever. Fever, right? I have a cough. A cough, right? Ah, look, Rolando. I have a toothache.
Oh.
A toothache, right?
Okay.
I have a cold. A cold, right? I have a runny nose. Okay. Runny nose means ando mucoso, right? A runny nose. Now, please, repeat after me. I have an earache. I have a pain in my chest. I have a pain in my ribs. I have a fever. I have a cough. I have a toothache. Toothache. I have a cold. I have a runny nose. Good. Any question? Questions? Don't get the questions to yourself, right? No se queden con las preguntas. Preguntan si no entienden.
En negativo, teacher.
I don't have.
Okay.
I don't have. Because it's in present, right? So we use the auxiliary do or does. So you can say, she doesn't have an earache. I don't have an earache. They don't have an earache, right? Okay. Good. So no questions? Let's continue. So now with I feel, right? Feel plus adjective. I feel bad. I feel dizzy. Ooh, dizzy, right? Okay. I feel nauseous. Ooh, nauseous, right? Okay. I feel weak. I feel short of breath. Short of breath, right? I feel nice. I feel better. I feel good. Like the song, right? I feel good. So good. So I feel good. Now repeat after me, please. I feel bad. I feel dizzy. Dizzy. I feel nauseous. Nauseous. I feel weak. I feel short of breath. Breath. Short of breath. I feel short of breath. I feel nice. I feel better. I feel good. Now, questions? Questions, questions?
Short of breath.
Short of breath is sin aliento. Con el, como cuando usted sube unas gradas y llega al final de la clase. Que si no puede ni respirar, ¿verdad? Bueno, lamentablemente en el país, este es uno de los síntomas del coronavirus, ¿verdad? Que cuesta respirar. Short of breath. Corto de aire, corto de respiración. ¿Ok? Good.
Teacher.
Yes.
Lo mismo aplica lo que preguntaba el compañero en negativo.
Ajá, yes, I don't feel.
I don't feel.
Ajá, I don't feel.
I...
No me siento bien, por ejemplo, I don't feel good. I don't feel good. Right?
Okay.
O in third person singular, she doesn't feel good. Rolando doesn't feel good. No, no, right? Rolando feels good.
Hombre.
Okay, now, any other question? Do you understand what is weak? Débil, right? Débil. Casualmente es otra de las características del coronavirus, ¿no? Uno se siente bien débil. Yes? Okay, dizzy is mareado, right? Dizzy. Si alguna vez fueron a la puerta del diablo y se asomaron ahí al risco, dizzy, right? Okay. O alguien que se ha echado unas 12 cervezas, pues. Feel dizzy, right? Dizzy. Okay, now. Let's continue, right? Let's continue with the last vocabulary.
Teacher.
Yes, yes.
En el caso de lo que, el ejemplo que puso de la puerta del diablo, eso sería vértigo, pero no es lo mismo.
Ah, yes, 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 it's possible. But el vértigo causa mareo, right? Yes. So okay. That's why I say dizzy. Me siento okay. Mareado, right? Uh-huh. O maybe when you turn around, cuando uno se pone a dar vuelta. Los niños, ¿verdad? Que se ponen a dar vuelta de repente, dizzy, right? And nauseous okay. Es cuando usted va al mar por primera vez en su vida, se sube a un bote, pues. El movimiento del agua hace que uno se sienta con náuseas, nauseous, right?
Thank you.
Understand? Okay, good. Now, let's continue. Good, let me see. Lesson objective, the last one, right? Let me see who wants to help me reading. Alonso, please. Can you read the objective, Alonso, please?
Okay. By the end of the class, you will learn the name of common medication for health.
Thank you very much. Now, again, we have more vocabulary. Listen. An antibiotic. Cough medicine. An ointment. An antihistamine. Vitamins. Eye drops. A painkiller, a nasal spray, cold tablets, ¿ok? Después de esta clase todos vamos a terminar siendo médicos. Ok, repeat after me, please. An antibiotic. Antibiotic. An antibiotic. Cough. Medicine. Cough medicine. An ointment. It sounds strange, right? Like oint. Ointment. an ointment, an antihistamine, antihistamine. This is for allergies, right? Son antialérgicos, antihistamine, okay. Vitamins, eye drops, a painkiller, a nasal spray, cold tablets. Good, any question? Questions?
Painkiller.
Painkiller is like the aspirin, right? Es un, en español sería como un analgésico. No, sí, analgésico, right? De medicina no sé mucho, pero entiendo que es como la...
Alivio de dolor.
Un alivio del dolor. Pero la aspirina, ¿qué otras medicinas son parecidas a la aspirina?
Paracetamol, acetaminofén.
Acetaminofén, yeah, la acetaminofén is a painkiller. Yeah, thank you. Good. Now, another question.
An ointment.
Ointment is ungüento. Like Cofal, for example. Cofal is an ointment. Okay? Good.
Any other? What is the meaning? Cough medicine.
Cough, right? So medicine, okay. For the cough. Uh-huh. In this case, is syrup. Syrup is, in Spanish, syrup is jarabe.
Uh-huh,
correct. That is a cough medicine, right? Yes.
Okay, thanks.
Okay. Another question? Antihistamine is antihistaminico, right? It's, la que son para la alergia, ¿cómo se llama esa tableta?
Loratadina,
yes. Loratadina is an antihistamine, right? Okay, good. So, that is the PowerPoint presentation. Now we're going to go to the platform. Let me see. Yes. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, section 2. Word power, parts of the body. Okay? Now, let's watch the video. Let's watch the video together, right? Good.
Hi, everyone. In this class, you'll learn vocabulary for discussing different parts of the body. Let's get started by listening and practicing.
Parts of the body.
Head. Eye. Ear. Nose.
Mouth. Tooth. Teeth. Chin.
Back. Shoulder. Chest. Stomach.
Throat. Neck.
Wrist. Arm. Elbow.
Thumb. Hand. Finger. Fingers.
Leg. Knee. Ankle.
Foot. Feet. Toe. Toes.
Good. Now, just give me a second.
Make sure that you memorize this vocabulary. An easy way to do this is by pointing to your head.
Leg.
Just give me a second, please. Okay, good. So, do you have questions about vocabulary?
I have a question, teacher.
Luis, tell me, please.
With the thumb.
A thumb.
Yes.
It's the, look at my hand. Can you see my hand?
Yes.
This is the thumb. The thumb.
Oh, okay, el pulgar.
Yes, this is the let me see the
El aborto.
Yes, I know, but listen, I forgot the name of this. So this is a Pinky. Pinky, this is the ring finger. This is the el dedito malcriado, right? It's the middle. And this is, I don't remember very well. I guess it's the pointer, right? The punta, right?
Yes.
So those are the names of the fingers. Okay? Mm-hmm. Good.
And okay, teacher. And
wrist. Listen again. Ring, middle, pointer, and thumb.
Five.
Okay? Good. Any other question, Luis?
Yes. Wrist.
Wrist.
W, yes, W, okay.
Is muñeca, right? But it's no es la que la, la muñeca de la mano, right? The wrist. And it's similar to say cintura, that is waist. Waist. Cintura and wrist. Muñeca, right? Good. Continue, Luis. More questions?
Okay, teacher, thank you.
No more questions? No.
No, teacher, no.
Ya me había sentido feliz que me estaban haciendo preguntas. Come on, the rest of the class, do you understand?
Yes, teacher.
Yes, Alejandro, yes, no question.
No.
Okay, thank you. Now, toe, look, toe, and toe, toenail means uñas de los pies. Ahí no está, pero es toenail, es uña de los pies, right? Okay, good. Now, any other question? So, let's go to the practice, right?
Knee.
Make sure that you memorize this vocabulary. An easy way to do this is by pointing to your head and expressing, this is my head. Then pointing to your arm and saying, this is my arm. Remember, the goal is to learn this vocabulary. So,
okay, look, this is the exercise, right? Now we're going to do it together, right? Let me see if we made it. Open your cameras, please. Open your camera. And you're going to say, this is mine. This is mine. Example, right? This is my head. This is my nose. This is my chin. This is my finger. This is my hand. Okay, now, let's start with Josue. Josue, welcome, Josue. Open your camera, Josue. Okay, sorry, Josue. Está en el patio. Ah, yes, I see, okay. Now, give me one example. Josue, give me one example. This is mine.
This is my glass.
Okay, these are my glasses, right? These are my glasses, okay.
All my glasses.
Well, I suppose the glasses are part of the body in your case, right? Because they are necessary. Okay, thank you. Thank you very much. Alonso, please give me one example. Saying this is mine.
This is my elbow.
Excellent, very good. Please don't use your elbow when you invite, please. Alonso, cuando hago una invitación, no uses su elbow. Understand? Okay, thank you. Now, Victor, one example, Victor.
Forehead.
Okay, this is my?
Forehead.
Repeat. This is my?
This is my? Forehead.
Excellent. Rolando, please. Rolando.
This is my neck.
Excellent. Alicia.
This is my eggs.
In this case, Alicia is, these are, because two, right? These are my?
My eggs.
Your eyes.
Eyes, pardon, excuse me.
Yeah, no problem, Alicia, don't worry. Elizabeth.
These are my ears.
Excellent. Billy. Ready, Billy?
This is my back.
Okay, nice. Monica.
This is my finger.
Okay, in this case, Monica, these are, right? Are, when it's plural.
These are my finger.
Excellent, good. Ana Maria.
This is my ear.
My head, right? My head.
No, cabello.
Ah, hair.
My hair.
Hair. Head. Hair.
Hair.
Hair. Hair, right? Okie dokie. Yeah. Anybody else? ¿Alguien más que pueda abrir su cámara? Eric, Abel. Ah, Ana Carolina. Hello.
Hello. Ahora no. Ya me sirve el micrófono, teacher. Oh. Hace un ratito no me escuchaba.
Yes, I can hear you very well. Okay, give me one example, Carolina.
This is my mouth.
Ah, okay, good. Thank you very much. Thank you to everybody. Now let's continue because we almost finished the class. Casi se nos acaba la hora, así que vamos a seguir. Let me see. Oh, here. Okay. We're going to watch the last video.
Adjective. Let's analyze these different illnesses. For example, I have a headache. I don't feel well. Let's get started by listening to a conversation titled, I Feel Homesick.
I feel homesick.
Hey, Kenichi, how are you?
Oh, I'm not so good, actually.
Why? What's the matter?
Well, I have a headache and a backache.
Maybe you have the flu.
No, I think I just feel a little homesick for Japan.
That's too bad. But maybe I can help. Let's have lunch at that new Japanese restaurant.
That's a great idea. Thanks, Brian. I feel better already.
Now let's take a look at the examples on this chart.
Have plus noun. Feel plus adjective.
What's the matter? What's wrong?
I have a headache. I have a backache. I have the flu.
How are you? How do you feel?
I feel homesick. I feel better. I don't feel well.
Negative adjectives.
Sick. Awful. Terrible. Miserable.
Positive adjectives.
Fine. Great. Terrific.
Great.
Fantastic.
I would like to start by explaining the examples on the left-hand side of this chart. How to form statements with have plus noun. We can follow this formula to do that. Subject plus have plus noun. Let's analyze the first example. I have a headache. The subject is I. Then we need to put have. Finally, we include a noun, a headache. Let's take a look at one more example. I have the flu. The subject is I. Then we need to put have. Finally, we include the noun, the flu.
The flu.
Now, I would like to show you how to form statements with feel plus adjective. We can follow this formula, subject plus feel plus adjective. Let's analyze the example, I feel homesick. The subject is I, then we need to add feel. Finally, we need to put an adjective, homesick, or it can be any of these adjectives towards the right. I feel sick, awful, terrible, miserable, fine, great, terrific, fantastic. Now it's your turn to practice giving examples of your own. Try to use the vocabulary and try to make examples using have plus
your microphone, teacher. Su micrófono está apagado.
No le escuchamos, teacher. El micrófono está apagado, teacher.
Oh, sorry. Excuse me. Decía que aquí ya tenemos el primer comentario de Ana Alvarado, right? Congratulations. Pero necesito sus comentarios. I need your commentaries, please. Okay? Good. So, I need you finish this, right? Necesito que me hagan este laboratorio, right? So, you listen to the conversation, listen, and you answer, right? Okay? Look, one of the three options here, right? That's it, right? And we miss a video, right? Nos quedó un video pendiente, nada más. Pero lo vamos a ver el lunes. We're going to see it on Monday, okay? That's it. Now, do you have any extra question? Do you have any extra question before we finish?
¿Qué actividad tenemos que completar en esta última sesión?
The 2.4, 2.4.
Okay.
Es decir, ustedes pueden hacer cualquier parte de las cinco secciones. ¿Ok? Pero en la clase vamos a ir explicando una por una, ¿sí? En este caso, la que quisiera yo que sí completara en la 2.4 para que juntos la hagamos el lunes, ¿ok?
Ok.
Thank you very much. So, God bless you. See you on Monday. Monday. Remember, we have classes on Monday, right?
Right. Okay.
Okay. Goodbye. Have a good night. See you Monday.
Bye.
Have a nice weekend.
Bye, teacher. Thank you.
Bye-bye.